Hello everyone, and welcome to another Strixhaven Traditional Draft. Okay, the pack is having a few first pickable cards. The rare is what I'm gonna pick. Lawhold Command is very good, and of course, even though it is two colors, it is the first pick here. It is also splashable, so you can splash it in black and white or the blue and red archetype. Other first pickable cards here, I think, are the Devouring Tendrils, and I could first pick the Creative Outburst. It is a fairly strong card, and when you go to the Prismari deck early, you can usually find ways to, you know, make the 7 mana cards happen. But Lawhold Command is very strong, and I will pick that. I mean, it is the best card in the pack. Another Creative Outburst here. Pretty funny. It would be interesting to start with two of these, although you don't maybe want to play two of these in the deck. Okay, that was wrong. You can play two, but would you start the draft with two of those? I mean, 2 7 mana cards, that means it's kind of tough to pick more 7 mana cards. For instance, the Elemental Masterpieces, which are still very reasonable 7 mana cards to play in a deck. But let's just focus on what I'm gonna pick here, because I took the red-white card. I'm not going to pick the blue-blue-red-red card here now. Lawhold Excavation, I don't think it's very good, and it's definitely possible it comes back to me as pick number 10. So the decision here is between Environmental Sciences and Pigment Storm, I think. And I will take the Environmental Sciences. This 5 mana removal is okay, but I already have a 5 mana card in here. So I'll just take the Sciences now, because it's gonna be good no matter what. No matter what colors I'm gonna play, it's gonna be a fine card. I mean, better than fine. It's gonna be an excellent card. Okay, so here I have seen... I have passed some Prismari cards, those two uncommons, 7 mana uncommons, and also I passed the 7 mana common in the previous pack. And this pack has Spectacle Mage, Maelstrom Muse, so I'm gonna pass one of those anyway. Even if I pick the Muse, which is the better of those two, so I could take the Muse here. Or I could take something like a Guiding Voice, if I think that I could draft Lorehold. Guiding Voice is a very good card, and I already have a good lesson here, but I think it's time to pick the Muse here. If Prismari is going to be open, this is no indication of Prismari being open quite yet, because it's pick 3, but if it's going to be open, I definitely want to have the Muse here, and I can still splash the Lorehold command in that case. Okay, there's a Quinteros, so a pretty interesting card in the sense that it would be an interesting card to have this early in the draft for a Lawhold deck, because then I could get the synergy for it, because there's so many, you know, picks left in the draft. But I just took the Maelstrom Muse, which kind of puts me to blue-red. And there is an Arcane Subtraction and an Enthusiastic Study. If I take the Lawhold, the Historian here, I would have 2 5 mana cards for Lawhold. I'm not a fan of that idea. I think I will just take the Study here. That will keep me open for both Prismari and Lawhold. And it's a fine card no matter what. Okay, so what does this pack tell me? It tells me red is open. Because I think the Academic Dispute is quite good. It's still here. There's also Pigment Storm, which is not, you know, amazing, but it's still here. So I don't think it's a big signal, but it does mean that, well, in combination with the Dispute, that tells me that red is open. So I should be either red, white, or red, blue for sure. So I think I'll take the Dispute. I like it quite a bit. A 1 mana learn spell, which can, you know, get you a free kill occasionally too. And even if it doesn't, for 1 mana you can get the best lesson for the situation you're facing currently. So I'll take it. because I'm sure I'm going to play red here. And what I said about the Lawhold Excavation, it's not a very good card. I could play it in Lawhold deck, but there's an Illustrious Historian which works quite well in both Prismari and Lawhold. And I will be playing red for sure here, so I'll take that. It's a fine two drop. I mean, it's better than fine. It's a better two drop than an average two drop is. Wow, well, this pack. So look at these blue cards. So there are 9 cards left in the pack, and 5 of them. So over 50% of the cards are mono blue, and that wouldn't be such a surprise if the cards were bad. But Snow Day is fine. And I guess the Befuddler is, you know, it's playable. It's not an amazing card. And Solve the Equation, I think it's the worst card. But Arcane Subtraction and Burying Books, these are very, very good cards, both of them. I will take the Burying Books here. It is better than the Subtraction, especially when I have already 2 learned cards and only 1 lesson. Ferment Mastery is unplayable, basically. So I will take that. I think I'll take the Campus card because this seems like I could be Prismari splashing for the Lawhold command, and this thing works well when you're splashing something, and the pack really was quite weak. Creative Outburst is here. Okay, this was my pick, pack 1, pick 1. No one took it, so Prismari is definitely open, and I'm going to play Prismari here, and I take the Creative Outburst here for sure. There is the Archway Commons, which I wouldn't mind having because I'm going to splash the Lawhold command, but the Creative Outburst is good enough to not pick the land. Here it's a decision between Fuming Effigy and the Archway Commons, and here, because I do want to splash for the Lawhold command, even if it's the only white card in the deck, it is so good that I will be splashing it for it anyway, so I will take the land that allows me to splash it easier. And here I take the Spectacle Mage. Okay, so basically Prismari is not drafted here. Definitely this is the archetype I should be in. So I'll take the Spectacle Mage here. Here I'll take 20 gems because pack has nothing for me otherwise. This is a rare. And here I'll take Prismari Campus, which is fantastic. I wouldn't mind playing the adept maybe, but it's not important. And the land is just, you know, kind of a free way to fix mana. I don't like Curate, I like the Fuming Effigy. I don't like it in the sense that it doesn't seem to be a good card, but it's a better filler card than the 2 mana instant speed. You know, the thing that I just passed. What was it? Curate, yeah, so. Yeah, I think this is slightly better. I can still cut it from the deck though. Here, the options are. I have 1 Environmental Sciences, so I don't think the second one is important. No, it's not. And I do like the Transformation, but this has a very high chance to be in the pack as pick number 9, so I'm not going to pick it now. This is a lesson that is rarely useful, but when it is, it's really good. So it's a nice option to have in your blue deck, blue deck's sideboard, but it's not really that important card because it's not such a high impact card as the Environmental Sciences is. I think because I'm going to splash for white anyway, I'll take the Rip Apart over the Serpentine Curve here. Archmage Emeritus. Yeah, that's gonna be the pick. How many 4 mana cards I have here? Some, but the effigy is okay. I have basically 2, and the effigy is cuttable. This can just draw you a bunch of cards. I don't know yet how many Magecraft triggers I'm gonna have. So far, I have 6 out of 6, so 50% of the deck is Magecraft triggers. So currently, it seems like I have a bunch of ways to draw cards with this thing. I think this is a pretty easy pick over the cards I have here. Yeah, the other cards aren't that great. I mean, the study is okay, but I have already 1 study, so pretty easy. Archmage Emeritus here. Okay, there's Witherbloom Apprentice, which is the best card in the pack, in my opinion. Completely not in my colors, and the Umbral Duke and the Mage Hunter's Onslaught are decent cards too, but of course doesn't work in my colors. So I take the Mentor's Guidance. I have couple of summons, three wizards. Yeah, okay. Usually you don't have trouble to find the whatever color combination you are playing. You usually have enough of these creature types to get the additional copy of the spell. And this pack is fairly weak for my colors. It's good otherwise, but for my colors it's fairly weak. I take the Mentor's Guidance here. Grape Shot, Quandrich Pledge Mage, and well, there's a lesson, but that's not important. This is an okay lesson, but nothing like you don't usually get this. You get it only if you have like no other options or something like that. The Pledge Mage I like quite a bit. The Grape Shot isn't bad, but usually it is like 2 damage, and 2 damage for 2 mana is not that great, especially if it is sorcery speed. So I think I'll take the Pledge Mage. It is, in my opinion, a higher impact card. Also the Warden is good, but I like the Pledge Mage even more. Okay, this pack has the options that I should consider are Kelpie Guide, Pigment Storm, and Tome Shredder. I do like the guide because it untaps, you know, also lands. So basically this, among other things, this is a 3 mana 2/2 that basically taps for mana. And that can be very good as a 3 drop. Yeah, I definitely pick the guide over the Shredder, and this is a 5 mana removal spell. It's a lot of mana. I think the Kelpie Guide is what I should have here. Of course, it has the upside of, you know, when you have 8 lands or more, it can also be a tapper, which is very strong, of course. This pack, let's see how many 2 mana cards I have. Not a lot. I think, yeah, the decision is between the aerial, that is not great in this archetype at least. It's between Pillar Drop Warden and the Historian. I think I still should take a 2 drop, so I'll take the Historian here. Oh, wow, what is this? Oh, come on, what? This is pack 2, pick 7. The cards I wouldn't mind having here are Negate, maybe even Wormhole Serpent, Master Muse, Pigment Storm, Spectacle Mage, and the Prismari Pledge Mage. All of those 6 cards are cards I wouldn't mind having. I can pick only one of them, and none of them is gonna come back to me. I think I'll take the suggestion here, the Master Muse, but oh man, this pack was so crazy. I hope I have... Oh, come on, you are joking. Look at this. I had 6 cards from which I only could pick one for my deck, and this pack has nothing I want to play. Wow! So couldn't there have been a bit more spread with the cards from the previous pack? I mean, some of them could be here, and some of these could be in there. I don't have any clue. I guess I take the reject. It's a fine sideboard card, but oh man, that was so sick, because I would have taken so many of the other cards from the previous pack over reject. Well, that doesn't work like that. Okay, I'm splashing for white, but I don't think any of these is that great. I'll take the 20 gems in the Auric Lore Mage. Okay, Spell Satchel. I have 7 triggers for it. I don't think it's enough. I have one of these Befuddlers already. I'm not gonna play 2. So I take the Teach by example, in just in case I find, I will put it to the sideboard for now, but if I find some, you know, more cards I want to copy with it, maybe I could consider playing it. So now this pack has the Battleseer and basically Assistant. I'll take the Battleseer instead, but let's put it to the main deck, I suppose. Not sure if I'm going to want to play it, but it's in the main deck for now. Pillar of Warden. Yeah, that's fine. Well, okay, this pack has the Pigment Storm. I'm gonna play it, pick it now, and well, I'm gonna only splash for white, so the Apprentice won't work. I'll take the Adept. Reject number 2. Okay, wow. Well, the decision here is between the two rare cards, Electrolyze and the Ingenious Mastery. The Ingenious Mastery is very good in the very late game. But this thing also draws a card. Is it interaction? Yeah, I guess when in doubt, when you don't know which one of the options you are deciding between, when they are close to each other in power level, pick the cheaper one. That usually works as a guideline. I take the 3 mana card over the, the 6 or 7 mana card, because this is only good when you can sink 6 or more mana to it. This is always good when you have a 3 mana card. If nothing else, you can, at least draw a card, but usually you get a 2-for-1 for this, even though the card you remove with it isn't such a high impact card, but it's still fine. Alright, this pack. Wow, I think I take the Spirit Summoning here. It's a fairly weak pack. I could take the Reconstruct History, but no, not really. I have only 3 sorceries. It's not a very good chance to take even 2 cards with it. Yeah, I'll take the Spirit Summoning here. It's a fairly weak pack for me. Okay, here. Wow. This is also a weak pack. I could take the Archway Commons to make it even a bit more easier to splash for the white 2 white cards I'm going to splash. But I think the Introduction to Annihilation is still the card I'm gonna pick here. And here it's, yeah, Kelpie Guide. But I think, let's see, I have 23 cards already. Is there something I want to absolutely cut? Well, I could cut the Befuddler, Soothsayer Adept, Fuming Effigy. The Kelpie Guide is okay, but I have a lot of, well, I don't have that many 3-drops actually. But I think I still take the Fractal. Yeah, it is a good lesson. It's a good enough lesson. I'll take it. And here, Heated Debate. Okay, well, that is pretty obvious pick here. I play blue-red here, so the Heated Debate is an easy pick, very first pickable card even. Here, Elemental Masterpiece, Frost Trickster. Those are the options I'm gonna decide between. I think the Masterpiece is slightly more, relevant here than the 3-mana flyer. Yeah, I'll take it. Oh, what is this? Killian pick number 7. Oh, it is pack 3, but this kind of means that there are not a lot of Silver Quill drafters, because this is going to be a high priority for Silver Quill drafters. For me, there's like a Tomb Shredder. I think I'll take it. Sure. But yeah, Killian pick 7. If I was Silver Quill for some reason, that would have been such a gift. Torrent Sculptor number, this is pack 3, pick 8, the last pack in the draft that I haven't seen. So, I could also splash for the Returned Past Caller, but I think I'll take the rare. Because the Sonata is also quite okay. I have a couple of these 7-mana cards. I can exile. Yeah, I'll take the rare here. Here. Another warden and an archivist for maybe like a sideboard use. I have one of these adepts. Yeah, I will be cutting a bunch of cards here. So let's see. It's gonna be the archivist for the sideboard or the second warden. I think I like the archivist for in the sideboard slightly more here. And here. I'll take the Make Your Mark for the sideboard, maybe. And here I have 2 rejects. I'm never gonna play a third one, so let's just take an uncommon here. I don't need green for anything. Curate is just filler. I will never have room for it, so let's take, I don't know, the runner. That's 27 non-lands among all these cards I have here in the deck. I guess the sideboard doesn't have Yeah, it doesn't have cards I'm interested in running. How many 2-drops it is? Befuddler, Adept, Historian, Campus Guide. Not a lot. I will cut one of them, but I can't cut all of them. So, because I do want to have a certain amount of 2-drops. I cut the lands for now. I have a bunch of lessons here, I think. Sciences, summoning, annihilation, and I think I have 2 learn cards only. That's correct. I will play both of them. I will play 17 lands in this deck, so I will cut 4 cards. One of the 2-drops. I think the suit, say, Adept should go because I have 2 of these 7 mana cards, so I won't be looting lands away that often. I guess I'll play the Befuddler and these history. The histories are good always. The Campus Guide works in the splash. Befuddler is fine. And then about the 3-drops. 4-drops. It's gonna be the Fuming Effigy for sure. And then I think the Ogre Battleseer should go. This is kind of a 3-drop too. But I have one more cut. I think it is going to be a 3-drop. How many triggers for Magecraft I have now? 11. It also means that's 11. And that's not counting the lessons I can get with the learn cards. That also means 11 cards plus the lessons for the Tome Shredder. But I'm not going to cut the Spectacle Mage. It's very good with the Elemental Masterpiece, Creative Outburst, even Lord Command, Pigment Storm, and the Bearing Books. Yeah, it's very good here. And I think the Warden is good also. That is 5 4-mana cards. Although the Sonata has an option to, you know, I mean, the Sonata makes this Torrent Sculptor not always a 4-mana card. I feel like it's a Tome Shredder. It's very similar to the Quandrich Pledge Mage, but I guess the Pledge Mage is a double caster. Tome Shredder can also utilize the cards that have been cast before I play the Tome Shredder. This only works for the things that I play after it's been, you know, played. Okay, I guess I will cut it because I have so many 3-drops and I want to play the Kelpie Guide. This is also very good because of these 7 mana cards. This can just untap a land and, you know, allow the casting of these a turn earlier, which can be huge. This says Cleric, Druid, Shaman, Warlock, Wizard. So I guess with these colors, it's more like a Wizard and a Shaman. Let's see how many of those I have. 5 Wizards, 3 Summons, it's 8. Yeah, it's enough for the Kelpic, the Mentor's Kindness. I think this is the deck. Yeah, this is the deck. So I will play one Plains. Let's take the Mirage one, which I can fetch with Campus Guide or the Environmental Sciences if I draw one of my 2 learn cards. And I have the Archway Commons, which is also able to produce white. So I think I have enough. That's basically 4 ways to produce white. Campus, no, that's actually 5. So Academic Dispute and Study can both get the Environmental Sciences. That's like 2 ways to get white. And then there's the Campus Guide, which can also get me white. Plus both of these lands, if I draw these, they can get me white. So that's 5 white sources for 2 spells, which is definitely enough. And the rest of the lands are the Prismari Campus. I don't think there's anything else I picked in the draft. Nope. So the rest will be basic lands. And 7 plus 7 is one possibility. 12 plus 16. I need white. I don't need white early, but I need blue and red. I need a red slightly more, but I have a double blue card here. With the commons which can produce both blue and red, and a Cambus which can produce both blue and red. I should put 7 and 7, which makes the overall mana base 9 plus 9, plus bunch of ways to get the white. Of course, the Cambus guide and the learn cards can allow me to get also blue and red mana, not only white mana. So I will play 7 planes. Let's take them. Okay, let's take this. What did seven? Oh, did I say 7 planes? I meant 7 basic lands for blue and red. I don't know what I was talking about. Here I will take this one, 7. Okay, that is 9, 9, and 2, plus all the fixing I have here. At least that's the main deck. Okay, so I'm on the draw. It's not a great hand, but I have 3 mana and the removal spell. I can use this to learn. If nothing else, I get a 3/2. Okay, I will keep it. I mean, this of course requires opponent to play a creature. And I'm not sure if I have the 3-drop here already, so I'm not gonna play it. I'm not gonna make a treasure. I have 4 mana here already. Let's mage. Sure. What should I do here? I could just kill it. This is a shaman, so it works with this, but. I'll play the flyer. Let's see what they do. Okay, well, I guess it's gonna be. Oh, the command is very good, of course. But I will kill the effigy. I don't wanna take at least 6 damage there. So let's do it before now that they are tapped out. I will attack for 2, and next turn I will have because I drew the planes, and I can cast the Lawhold command, which is pretty nice. And of course the outburst here only requires 1 more blue source. And if this survives, it can be a 6 mana card. That is very good. I can't kill it with the Lawhold command, sadly. S unless I use the dispute, but that doesn't work here, does it? No. Oh, I can give it reach. But it doesn't work. I can't cast both of them. Okay, that's bad. That is bad. What should I do? Oh, Lawhold Command is a four mana spell now, of course. Because of the Spectacle Mage, I can cast a Dispute and a Command. So that is fantastic. That is very fantastic. So I can make a 3-2 token. I can give my creatures +1 and +0 and indestructible and haste. So it will be a 4-2 hasty token, and then I can say that this must block and I won't give it reach, so they can't block the Spectacle Mage. They have to block the token, which will survive. So that's pretty easy now. Okay. Yep. So this must be the correct choice, right? At least I think it is. And then I say dispute here, and no, you don't get reach. And I will get a card here even. It is going to be this is double blue. I don't have the blue here now. Should I take the spirit summoning? Environmental sciences. I could take the spirit. I take the spirit summoning here, yes. I will attack with both. They have to block the 4-2 and it has indestructible for this turn, so it's fantastic for me. Air released, that's fine. Oh, I drew the island, but I can't kill this because it has ward 2. So I have a 6 mana available. Could play the spirit and the mentor's guidance. I think I play this first because this is a shaman. Unless they have a 2 mana removal spell or 1 mana removal spell, I get to draw 2. Let's do it first. Oh, they have something. Yeah, I will draw that for sure. Then I get the other copy. Well, I will draw that too. Okay, fine. And then I can play the spirit summoning. But yeah, I will block the aerialist for sure. That does mean I can't cast my seven mana cards unless I draw the one more land. But if I don't draw a land, I can, you know, cast all the other spells in my deck. Because these are the only seven mana cards I have. So if I draw a non-land card, I can cast it. I can draw a tapped land though, but I can still have the Muse and the Historian as playable spells. Okay, they go for the aggression, which is acceptable for them. I mean, they drop me to 5 here. And this has first strike, so I can jump block it, but I can't draw it. I don't think I'm gonna jump block it. I could lose if I with this risk, but I okay. Well, this is very good. Because now I can. Because of course they are also being in the, you know, range to die. They are all, they, by the way, almost die here because I can deal 5 damage to them, but that's only 11 total and they are at 12, so I can't kill them sadly. I will attack with both, that's for sure. So I think I should just play 2 creatures here, right? Because I wanna block this. If they kill the Muse, the flyer isn't gonna be enough. They would have to have a kill spell for the Muse and then a pump spell for the aerialist or like a shock to, you know, burn me away. But I will lose to that combination of cards anyway, right? So I think I just should play the Muse and the Historian. I can block both of those things. And now I will jump block with the Historian. I will block those both if they just attack without doing anything before combat starts. If they have 2 removal spells, yeah, well, that is not enough. They will need another Okay, there's no. Okay, now this means I will win the game. In many ways. They have one Dreadmon available. If it's a shock, I will lose anyway. How do I? Yeah, I will just attack, and they will lose. Yeah, they will. They will get. They will be at one, and then I kill them with the outburst. So, Prismari Mirror. What does my sideboard have? Reject. Pledge Mage. Make your mark. Is something here not so great? Like the Befuddler? I don't know. Should I play the Archivist? Because they have the 3-1 flyer here. This can kill it though. Maybe not. Do I want to play Reject? It counters the Nasari. It can counter this. Maybe I shoot. I don't know. Maybe I take the Befuddler away and I will play one Reject when I'm on the draw at least. Yeah, let's do that. I guess I will. No. The problem with this hand is that this is a 5 lander and I have all the mana. But if I want to cast the Rip Apart, I would have to use the Canvas Guide and put one, you know, the planes on top of my deck. Which would be very bad when I'm keeping a 5 lander. I think I want better of Malekan in this. I am. That is better. And I really, out of these cards, I think I should. I should get lucky here. I will cut the island. If I don't draw the lands, I will draw spells I can play, most likely at least. I can use the Flamethrower Sonata to kill that thing. Pitching something like a Pigment Storm. But I don't have to do it right away. But maybe it is better to do it. Yeah, it is. Okay, so should I play the Campus Guide? Okay, that's a pretty interesting. Let's see the situation here, because I can't cast the Tomb Slayer. If I play the Archway Commons, I won't be able to do anything else, because it will tap one of these two lands and this will enter tapped. And if I play the Campus Guide, I can guarantee the land drop for the next turn. Okay, I think I'll do it. I will have to miss my land drop now because the Archway Commons, you know, is very bad because you have to pay mana for it. So I think I'll take an island here. The Commons makes it so that I will have the one white mana available. So next turn I'm gonna play the Tomb Slayer, and then turn after that, well, I will see what I draw after that. Okay, they get the lands. I guess I could have attacked with this. Well, maybe I'll be exiled. I have only one thing to exile though. Whatever. next turn, if nothing else, I can play the Historian and the Commons. They still, they may need make the treasure token, so they have some expensive cards. But Nasari here, again. Sad. It is very good. So, let's see what happens. Can't attack. Can't do anything. Yeah, Nasari is... If I draw... let's see what they exile, but as you can see, the text is... So they exiled a reject. Well, at least they can't use it, because they will have to use it that turn, right? Until end of turn. Okay, yeah, they couldn't use it. I still can't kill Nasari, but maybe I should attack. Don't wanna play the Emeritus to draw a card with the command. If I attack with the Tome Shredder here. It's not good enough. I will play the Emeritus and hope to draw a card from it. They exile the land, so they can't play that. Okay, good. I was lucky in that. They exile. They get to trigger this twice, and they couldn't kill it. They couldn't use it in either case. But they killed now my thing there. Should I block that thing? I should. So let's hope to I will attack. They are not gonna block it. Now they get a heated debate. Well, that is annoying. Oh, that is so annoying. Yeah, I can't beat the Nasari. It becomes a 5-5. I can do things. I can make this indestructible and do something, but I can't kill this, and that's the problem. It's a 5-5 that keeps doing its thing. It's just too good. So I will just try to, you know, I will play the same deck and. Hopefully, if they get the Nasari, I have one of my removal spells. That's just a card that will win any game that drags for long. Sure, I can keep it. I need a couple of lands, but I have also ability to make a treasure token and maybe have this as a big ward guy. But let's see what I draw. Of course, if I don't draw any lands, I will just lose, but I took the risk. I have enough. If I draw the lands, my hand is very good. Okay, I will play this even if I can't copy it. Okay. That is a shaman though. I won't be blocking because if I draw a land, I can get a couple of... You know, I can get to copy this thing. Come on, land. So I will use the Torrent Sculptor because I want to try to throw land. I will, I use the Sonata here and I will discard the Enthusiastic Study, I guess. And I will kill that thing. And yeah, I didn't draw land. I drew a Campus Guide though, which I can use as a land. I mean, I can use it to draw land on the following turn. It's very slow though. Okay, I drew the land. Opponent has only red mana available. I should play the guidance because it will get copied. This is a shaman. Hopefully they don't have like a removal here. We will see. They did it. I will take the land. And then I won't take the historian. Okay, land is fine. Okay. And they still don't have more than anything else. And okay, well, I can now debate that thing. That is good. Otherwise, it would be annoying, but now I can kill it with the debate. And I will do it, of course, right away. Okay, still only red, but they get the spell still. I mean, they haven't been able to play a bunch of stuff. I don't think I have any attack here. I don't. No, I don't. Campus Guide and Electrolyze, not relevant. So I will just play the board in here. It can get me back something. That warden can get nothing back. Yeah, but I have the masterpiece coming up. I have the 7 mana here. Okay, now they get their own Mentor's Guidance. We have the same deck, basically. They will scry the bottom, and then the other one is scry the bottom. Okay. They have 4 cards. Another Pledge Mage. Okay, that's enough lands. I don't need more. Well, the Electrolyze can kill the Pledge Mage, and I will do that. Draw a card, another land. What the heck? I mean, I know I needed lands, but that's a bit too many. Alright, whatever. Play this, play this, and I won't be putting a land on top of my deck. I have the white here available. Next turn I can play the 4/4s, but the 1/5 is annoying. Pigment Storm on that, okay, whatever. Sure. Let's put the 4/4s on the battlefield. I need to draw some non-lands here. Oh, come on. Let's deal 4 to them. They get a 3/2, but I do get my 3/2/2. That is nasty. As you can read. A land again. Come on, deck. 4, 8, 11 lands. Okay, that they are in the, because I know the bottom card is a non-land. The top 18 cards has 6 lands and 12 non-lands. Alright, so they have this thing, which is super annoying. Oh man, we... If I attack, they can double block with a 3/2 and a 1/5. Sure. They didn't do that. Why wouldn't they try to trade there? They took 4 for no reason, right? I mean, at least, I mean, they could have taken 4, but why didn't they also block with a 3/2 here? Okay. Well, that's good for me, definitely. They choose to bounce. why would they? Do they have a win there? But I have a burning books. I mean, they have one card, and then they just drew some other card. Pigment Storm there, right? Yeah, but I can't bounce. I will go to 8 here, but I have the burning books here. Did they draw something? Because they must have had the Pigment Storm in there. Well, let's bounce this. I will go to 3, unless they have a kill here. Oh, they drew. Oh, and I drew a land. Oh, come on, what the f... Okay, so I drew like a million lands in a row, and they drew a creature here. If they drew a land here, they would just die. If I attack with both, they will block and I will lose to their 4-4. If I attack with one, they can take it. Well, that's what I'm gonna do here, of course. But if they draw a land now, it's fine. If they draw a spell yet again, well, I lose, but what can I do? I mean, if I draw all lands and they draw all spells, then I will just lose. There's nothing else. Oh, they have that. Oh, I kind of forgot they have this thing. Yeah, okay. That was a bit too many lands I drew there. Pretty frustrating also, because when they made their attack, when I had the burying books, they didn't know that they're gonna draw the pledge mage. They knew that if I have some interaction there, and if they don't draw a creature or some, you know, removal spell, they will lose to my counterattack. I mean, it was probably still played correctly by them, but given the amount of cards in my hand, imagine this situation from their perspective. I had like 3 cards in my hand in there. So they had to think that the opponent has only lands there. Because if I had more interaction than just the one very books I had, they know they lose. So they were just think that even that though I had a million lands on the battlefield, they were like, okay, they must have, well, I mean, when they made the attack, they were thinking that the only chance that for the victory they have is that they make the attack and they assume I have only lands in my hand, which I did, of course. But yeah, any one of those lands, if they were a spell, I think I would have been in a lot better shape. Okay, 2 islands and all red cards. I will have to mulligan this. Well, this is not a lot better, but at least I have all the mana and I can cast the Lawhold command on turn 5, but this is not really an ideal hand. Yeah, this is really, I mean, my deck can do better. But what can I do? Maybe I draw good here. Let's see. So I can make a 3-2 for myself. I don't think that's worth it. Yeah, I can get an island here. Okay, that trade is fine for me. Pledge Mage, okay. No need. I mean, okay. If I don't play the dispute right now, I have no play for the next turn because I know I'm drawing an island. So I guess I should take the 3-2 now. Okay, I'll do it. Yep. Okay. Oh, what is this silver quill? Okay, there are three colors. Red, white, and black. So I think I'm gonna save this and kill this. That maybe makes the most sense. I guess I could have just, yeah, whatever. I could have just played it later on, but whatever. Got rip water. I can make this. This is gonna be a pretty okay. I don't need that many lands, but anyway, I can play this and make this a. It's gonna be about a 5/5. Yep. With ward 2. So heated debate won't kill it. Expel will kill it. They didn't have it. I'll play the land because if this dies I will want to get to exile it. And now I have the 5 mana open here, they will get to scry. On bottom, which is good news. But they have 3 cards in their hand. They can't be all nonsense. Okay, 2 cards. Well, I keep drawing lands, so I hope the opponent has 2 lands in their hand too, but otherwise I will die. Okay, they apparently have just lands also. They get to scry. Top or bottom. They are thinking a bottom, okay, good. So this is lethal now. They have to find something for the sculptor. If nothing else, a blocker. And jump blocker won't be good in the long run. Okay, they can, but they have to pay the 2, otherwise this thing gets countered. So this will be a 6/6 now. And they will get something from the side. Okay, yeah, that is. So they have to have a jump blocker for this thing. That's not good for them. That's not good for at all. Yeah. Okay, so they have a red white. It's red white, but they are splashing for black because of these 2 camp. I don't think they would play these 2 campuses. They already have a Lord campus. I mean, without needing the black mana for something, but it is a low hold deck. Lightning Bolt, Rip Apart. These cards are already very good. Should I take? I guess because they have a Lightning Bolt and Rip Apart, I should take the make your mark here. And what do I not need? I think the Befuddler is the worst here. So let's cut it. And that's it. Okay, opponent mulligans, but I have 3 mountains here. Double blue card, a white card, a blue card. I can cast only the his turn here. I will mulligan this. Okay, well, this is better. This is only two lands, but at least both colors are here. And I can cut maybe the Archmage because it's the toughest thing to cast. I can play the Muse if I draw any two lands. This at least requires two lands, and one of them has to be producing blue. So I could also cut the Rip apart here. Okay, I have a heated debate anyway. Maybe I'll cut the Rip apart after all. If I draw the island or other blue source, I can cast these and start drawing cards. Yeah, okay, maybe that makes sense. Okay, well, no lands. Two draws, two 5 drops. Sure. That could have gone better. Okay. So how many non-games am I gonna have in this event? I'll already flooded a bit. Okay, that has the block, so they will attack just with the first striker. Fine. You do that. At least I won't take damage this turn. There's the land at least. So, well, it's a bit too late here. They have 6 power. I guess that 2/4, if I draw a land on the next turn, it can be enough. So yeah, let's play the Spectacle Mage and trade with the Ige first year here. And hope to draw a land. To get the Muse, and then the 2/4 might hold the ground here, who knows. Breakthrough. Well, I'm glad they use it now, because that means the Muse can hold the ground. Perhaps if they don't have more tricks, they can cast a 3/2 here though. Okay, now if I draw a land right now, I might still win. I didn't draw a land, I can't win anymore against, what, 9 power. I can kill one of them. So, yeah, same deck. Well, the dispute can get me the lesson that gets me a land. It's slow, but whatever, let's just keep it. I mean, this hand is not ideal. I should have played the dispute. I mean, the mountain here, just in case they have a one drop. Well, they didn't, and I actually at least drew a land there. Do I care about? I think I'll play the Mentor's Guidance now. Well, they don't even play a creature. Although this is a wizard, this, yeah, and this, okay, this is too good combination. I won't be, yeah, I think I will actually make a treasure token with this thing. Because if they don't, okay, I don't even have to use a treasure here. If they don't have a removal for them, this thing, well, they do, maybe. It's a pump spell, could be a pump spell. But this will be an amazing in combination with this, because I will get to draw a million cards. Because this is a Magecraft, and this will be copied, I will get to, yeah, but they have a removal spell. Oh, they don't, well, that's good. Because as you can see, okay, I hope they just play the spirit here and I get to do this. I will draw about 4 cards next turn. Yeah, that would be insane. Come on, just play the spirit. Okay, good. And could be a Lash of Malice still. Please don't have it. Well, I mean, I guess they have like a guiding voice there. They're thinking about casting it. They can do it. Maybe they're thinking that because I had a priority stop because of the academic dispute, that I might have a shock or lightning bolt to cast with this treasure. And if they have a guiding voice, they don't want to risk, but yeah, they do, and yeah, they get to resolve it. But that doesn't matter because now I get to resolve my mentor's guidance. It will draw me 4 cards total. They can introduce to annihilation afterwards, but now we'll get to draw 4 cards. So let's do it. Don't have the white mana, but I have a treasure here. Don't think I need the campus guide. Oh, there's the planes. I don't need this one. Like so. That was nice. I have... I can't cast the Muse. I can... I don't have a lot of... I guess I can, yeah, use the Burying Books to get rid of the 4-3 here. Yeah. I guess I'll sacrifice the treasure here. Yeah, I will sacrifice it. Can't really save it. Another Muse. Okay. They can use the introduction to annihilation, but then I draw a card, they use their turn, I will have another Muse, and I don't need a discount for anything really. I have enough mana to cast my spells here. That's fine. Okay, so I can keep, yeah, I can use the dispute now to my advantage, unless they have something for that one mana. Electrolyze. Well, that is great. So, first of all, let's see if I can attack. I can. And then I keep this. I will give reach to the theorist here. I will take the fractal summoning. They have to block now the flyer here. Oh, I messed up. I did mess up. That's sad. I'm still in a good shape, so it doesn't matter that much, but I could have played the Electrolyze and another Muse this turn. But now I can only play one of them, because the academic dispute took the discount from this thing. I could have played this just with blue and red. Oh, but I didn't have enough red mana, right? Oh, yeah, that's right. This would have cost red mana, and this cost... Yeah, I didn't have enough red mana for it. Okay, so I didn't screw up, actually. Yeah, I never had the red mana to cast the Dispute, the Muse, and the Electrolyze here. I had only 2 red mana here. Okay, they have a lot of those Pigment Storms, alright. That's fine. Oh, that's a good one too. That's very good. I mean, all my cards in the hand are so high impact. I'm just trying to think about. Yeah, I will attack for two and then play the masterpiece. Yeah. Yeah, this does discount too for the fractal summoning. So currently, if this survives, it will be a 7/7. That is dead. I draw a card and they attack. Yeah, I'll take three here. It has first strike, so I don't want to block it because they have something with one mana and they can kill this for free. I'd rather just use the electrolyze. I think I will take the discount. I'm not gonna play the fractal summoning this turn. Yeah, the opponent still has three cards I don't know about. That could be a bunch of things, including mass removal, so I shouldn't play all the cards here. I will kill this thing though. Okay, so well, Tome Shredder has a lot of stuff to eat, so I will play that and start eating. If they have a mass removal spell, they must use it right now, and I have still some stuff here. Okay, well, that dies. No mass removal then. Okay, that returns something. That's not really useful for them. No, it's not. Yeah, if they want to double block, be my guest. So if I know they're taking six. I could make it 9, and then the Pigment Storm is additional 3, but I don't have 2, I have only 2 red, so if I had a third red, I would win here, because this is, if I kill a 2 toughness creature with this thing, it deals 3 to them, and this deals 6, so they're at 6 basically now, and this gives, you know, they basically go to 3, but if I use this, I don't have mana to use this. So there's no reason to use the study right now. I don't think my sideboard has any less on that really. Oh, but I have the sciences. If I get a... Yeah, okay, I do have it. I do have the mana for it. Because I can get a mountain with this thing. Yeah, right. I hope I'm right. Yeah, this gets a mountain. I can play it. Okay, yeah, that was a complicated line perhaps, but this is enough to win. Alright. I'm glad I checked the sideboard. Well, I have a dispute for the sciences, which can the environmental sciences, I mean, which can get me a land. If I just draw the land naturally in three draw steps, I can, play the spectacle mage. Let's hope they don't have too aggressive of a start. But they do have something, sadly. Well, that is a cram session. That doesn't affect the board, so that's no big deal. Let's see what they get with it. With 3 mana, no lesson is that impactful if they get the pests. Well, they get the pests, but I don't care about it. And I even drew a 2-drop. Wow, that's fantastic. Of course, the pests are fairly decent against this, but this will return as a 3-2 later in the game. Field trip, okay. So they are going to. Another pest summoning? Prismatic Compass. Okay, I will take the flyer now. The flyer doesn't care about the 1/1 pests. Okay, and that's what they do. And a Biogrowth. I can Pigment Storm if I draw a land, and I did. Although, the Emeritus here. Yeah, I guess I'm gonna be greedy here. I will play the Emeritus first. Because then I can draw a card from the Pigment Storm. I can take 5 damage here. If they kill it, well, then they kill it, and then I use the Pigment Storm. Because they are not gonna kill both the Spectacle Mage and the Emeritus unless they have a. Well, they could have a double Mage Duel or something like that. Yeah, they could have a Mage Duel. Okay, they just play that. And. What else? Mage Duel. Only 2 mana available. Okay, they have a mage suit, yep. And hopefully they can't kill the spectacle mage at least. I don't think I'm gonna block the 1/1. I will take 6 anyway, I'm at 14. But the 2/1 is very bad against all these 1/1s. Maybe I should. Fine. Let's just block it here. Okay, the Pigment Storm should do the trick here. Well, I'm not gonna race, I'm gonna block. I am going to block here. This will be a 5/5 actually, when it exhausts the Pigment Storm. It's rounded upright. Yep. Okay, Master Symmetrist. Fine. That is fine. Six mana. Now they could have the infuse with vitality, which is the 2-mana death touch grinding thing, plus it returns the creature back to play from graveyard if it dies, and it gains 2 life. But thing is that if they attack, do I want to block? Okay, Professor, that's fine. No attacks, all right. Okay, well, that is good. That's very good. Yeah, 6 mana, I can play that and the Tome Shredder. So let's just try to see if this works. Do they have the infuse with vitality? Snakeskin Whale, oh man. Well, that was annoying. Oh yeah. I guess I can still kill it with the dispute. Yeah, I can make it block and attack with the 5-5 only. They have to block the 5-5. This will trade. Yeah, that sounds good. That sounds good indeed, especially because I will get a lesson with this thing, which is gonna be the Fractal most likely. I hope they didn't draw something that is actually gonna work for them. Hopefully it's just a, you know, random creature, please. At least not anything like an instant speed interaction. Okay, they have that. Sure. That gets exiled and the spell gets exiled. No matter how I respond. Well, the opponent drew a pretty good card. A 2-for-1. 2-for-1 indeed. Yep. Well. So let's see. If I block now. If I block now, I save at least 5 damage. If I don't block, I will be at 9. I will use the dispute. Ah, did they have to have a Rise of Exodus there? I'll block. I need to get lucky anyway and draw something good. Yeah, sure. I could get the Fractal summoning, but because they have the introduction there, it makes no sense. I will wait until they use this thing. They don't have a Skryland, I do have, so I have a tiny bit of advantage here, but I don't know about the one card in the hand that is, you know, face down. I know they have two cards in the hand, and I know what is the other one. So the board doesn't allow them to attack. I mean, I can trade with the 3-2. But definitely I will scry here. That must be good enough. It doesn't get anything, but 1-5 here is actually quite okay against the board of theirs. So I will be playing it, and I think that's also meaning that I should attack with the 2-2 here. Yep. Another growth. Okay. Okay, electrolyze will be useful. Sure. There's nothing to return with the warden here. Yeah, they must understand that I have something in my hand, but of course it's pretty hard to tell what it is, and I don't know what they have in their hand. They have two cards I don't know about. So they got to exile that, that's fine. I'll draw a card. Kelby Guide will be pretty decent, it's almost able to tap something. They have only one card I don't know about. So let's have them attack here, and what is the way to go here? I think I just want to play it somewhat safe here, and I will play the Befuddler here and make this one be low power. I will jump this thing. I will block either 4 damage or I kill this thing. I think it's gonna be like this. I will take 5 here though. That's not nice, but maybe it is the best. Ambrose. Well, I'm gonna have to kill this anyway, but that's actually such a good card. I'm gonna lose to that. I'm going to lose to that. Unless I can. No, I can't. Oh man, the last card in the hand was an insane rare. I mean, it's not usually insane, but in this situation, it is insane. Well, let's see what I draw. I can bounce it. But it's just a temporary solution. I can't raise them. They're at 18, I'm at 5. The heck? They can just grow their guys for. Ah, yeah, so let's see if I force them to block. Well, that doesn't do anything right. Yeah, it doesn't do anything. I have to use the burying books here, right? Can I return? I guess I can force them to block, and then I return the electrolyze. That dies, but I will lose in that case. I don't have anything to block with. Oh man. Fine. Fine. Let's do that and attack for two. But I need to draw something good to deal with the Embros there. Did the opponent draw something good again? Oh man, if they did. Sure. Whatever. I'm just tired of. I know I can't tap this thing, but they're gonna draw Embros. If the opponent just keeps drawing insanely good cards, that's it. I mean, I can't beat them. Okay, another hand. I have to mulligan. Yeah, not a great event. Look at this hand. Only two blue sources, and this is a sick card. Six card hand anyway. Yeah, I guess it wasn't my event. Yeah, so many mulligans and flooding outs. I will cut here. I think the Ripper Path, the Lord Command, is the better white card to have here, if I even draw the white card at some point. But yeah, this is just, unless I draw specifically a red source, very soon I will just lose. So let's just... Okay, opponent Mulligan to 6, let's see if I can draw the red source. And it's not like the mana is bad in this deck, it's not, it definitely is not bad. I mean, it's a 9-9 mana here, so it should be quite okay. I think I'll play the 2-1 here now, not use the treasure token yet. And now I'll have to make a treasure token. Sure, they have a pretty good one. So... sure, let's play this. I will have to draw the red source at some point, right? The fact I drew the planes is pretty good, because now that means I can play the Lawhold Command if I just can find the red source. Well, unless this dies, but if I draw the red source, I can play another Muse in that case, and then maybe I can cast the Lawhold Command in that case. Okay, yeah, well, sure, let's not attack with anything. Okay, well, that was another event where I just can't play my cards despite mulliganing. Yep, they can, yeah, you can go off. I mean, how can I win here anymore? I can't. They get the, yeah, sure. Let's just, I can't beat those fractals when I have a 3 mana here. It's just, yeah, that was an event where I mean, I usually don't want to whine about mana issues, but now two matches, where, you know, lost because I had just bad mana draw, so that is part of the game, of course, but I don't wanna analyze this event any further. That was just a bad draws, and that's it. Next one will maybe be a Chromatic Cube, and then I will have still some Strixhaven before the Forgotten Realms gets released. Anyway, thank you for watching, even though it wasn't very exciting matches, but what can I do? It was what it was, and hopefully at least the draft portion was maybe interesting. I think Prismari was open there, and I got a pretty decent deck. The draws just weren't that good in this event now. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video. Bye-bye.